Our current exhibit is the Continental Divide Raceways, which was a premier racetrack that existed here in Castle Rock. It's a great story, and I know that not many residents know about it, and so we wanted to bring that to the people of Castle Rock.
Welcome to CDR, where the world's fastest dragsters and sports cars roamed. How's that? That's pretty cool.
Yeah, I like it.
I like it too.
The impetus was set by one of the members of the historic society that found out, didn't realize the CDR existed, and got fired up and started doing some research. Then we have a gentleman in town that has some of the model cars that he was willing to put on display to show the type of cars that were actually raced there, and in some cases, the models of the actual car that was raced there. We've got a photographer who was the actual official photographer at the track, and he got involved. And we do have a gentleman that lives in Castle Rock that actually raced at Continental Divide Raceways. And so he came in and he had a lot of stories to tell.
Continental Divide Raceway was located approximately 2.5 to 3 miles south of the center of Castle Rock. Basically, it was a road racing track. As it was being developed, they included a drag strip with it. The road racers used that as their main straightaway. It was one of the top national racetracks in both drag racing and road racing. Mario Andretti, he said in one of his books, this is one of his favorite tracks. The lifespan of CDR was basically first racing there in 1959. Last car race there was in 81. I think this is just a fabulous display and a fabulous opportunity for the people of Castle Rock just to see this display, because Continental Divide Raceway meant so much to them in the past. One of the nice things about the museum exhibit is once it's gone, there will be a permanent, smaller exhibit here at the museum.
It's really a unique exhibit, and it's really a neat one. It is definitely a part of Castle Rock's history, there's no question about that. We have a very unique individual here, Mr. Lionel Oberlin, who was instrumental, along with his wife, of establishing the museum back in the 90s.
Well, it's interesting. The railroad was built through here in 1870. And at the time, the gentleman who was behind the building of the railroad did not believe that there would ever be a town here, so he didn't put a depot here. Well, all of a sudden, Castle Rock started to grow, and he realized that he needed a depot here, so they built the depot in 1875, and it was here until much later. The railroad was going to destroy this building because it was a passenger depot, and they no longer had passenger service available. This couple heard about it. They went to the railroad and talked to them about it, and the railroad says, "We'll give you the building for $25 if you'll move it at your expense," which they did, and we have pictures of it being moved across town. It was not lived in by the people who bought it from the railroad, but by the brother of the wife of that group, of that couple. And he was the first person to live in here, and then other people lived here over the years, up until the Historic Society became interested in using it as a museum.
In 1996, the location here became available for sale, and so the Historical Society was able to purchase it and create a museum here for Castle Rock.
There is no charge to come to the museum, but a lot of people do make donations. We're open Wednesday and Saturdays in the afternoons. And our telephone number is 303-814-3164. Definitely, if somebody has some history of Castle Rock that would be interested in putting something on exhibit or display, we'd be more than happy to listen and see if we could work something out.